John Hopkins, when he mixes atmospheric and electronic, it's great. And I heard the track and I loved it.
I've been a fan of Seb Edwards, the director, for I guess as long as I've been shooting. He's kind of been a huge influence. Him and I almost immediately kind of were in sync in terms of ambient and where the piece was going to go atmospherically. What he was saying was exactly what I was thinking, which made the project much more exciting. This was a really good first project to do together. The city of Belgrade is so potent in locations. It's sort of, you can point the camera anywhere and it'll look amazing. We shot on the Alexa Mini with master anamorphics. We wanted to shoot anamorphic because it felt like it wanted to be anamorphic. And with the budget that we had and the locations that we had and so many night exteriors, the masters were sort of, there was really not another lens option. They're the fastest anamorphics out there and you can really shoot them wide open. I mean, they become soft, but in a very good way. So I really loved that about them. And the other thing about them that I really loved was that when I saw the locations, a lot of them had these straight lines and a lot of them were symmetric. So I knew if we went with some of the older anamorphic lenses or any kind of anamorphic lenses, on the wide end it would bow. So I love the masters because they don't distort, you know? There was no distortion at all. I thought of them as a tool to use for the look of anamorphic when you don't want the distortion, when you want the lines to be straight, you know, when you don't want really kind of heavy-handed flares, which we definitely didn't on this project. So they were sort of the right tool, but also kind of the only tool that existed in the market, you know, and still exists in the market. The piece is quite stylized, and the locations were quite stylized, and you know, if you add a lens flare to the image, then it makes it a bit more stylized. So we didn't want to do that. So I just felt like flares would just take away from what's happening on screen. I just think that an image without flare is more sophisticated. It's essentially a love story told in dance. We wanted to approach it in kind of classical, almost theatrical way. Luckily, the locations that we had were, they were lit reasonably well, and we, of course, augmented that with bigger units and lights that were hidden here and there, but that was why the Alexa and the masters were so important, because we shot the whole thing wide open, for sure, and some of it was shot at 800, some of it was shot at 1600, and that really helped. It really helped to have a camera that was that sensitive, and lenses that you can shoot at 1.9 and they're still very sharp. And you don't have to stop down to a 4 to get them to be sharp. To augment the windows and to augment the streets and stuff, we had sky panels that we had, I believe, on Octobanks or some sort of softbox, and then we diffused that even more to push a bit of a key or to give them an edge. We used the Alexa Classic 709 LUT that I found to be amazing, and we did very little in the color grade, actually. It takes a lot of guts for a colorist to do that, to not have his own kind of look. It ended up being almost identical to what I'd imagined what it looked like. So I don't think there was any kind of heavy-handed look that was done in post. It was all done in camera. I mixed a lot of sodium vapor with mercury vapor and cyan and an orange and that type of thing. I mean, those locations were very distinctive. You know, you look at them and there's not that many ways of lighting those locations. You know, to make them look naturalistic, there's not. There's color that you can add, but it's dance, you know, and it's quite a stylized script. So if we added a lot of color, it would have been the wrong approach, I think, at least, you know.